All right, so we've got two games to talk about. In the first game, the Canucks absolutely dominated the St. Louis Blues. Quinn Hughes was yucky all game. He opened the scoring with this beautiful shot past Binnington and then later made it 2-0 thanks to a lucky bounce. But watch how he sets up the scoring chance right from the faceoff. This guy's skating is insane. Oh, and by the way, Hughes and Hronek are quietly turning into one of the best shutdown defensive pairs in the league, and I couldn't be happier about that. And speaking of defensemen, guess who showed up this weekend? The Chaos Giraffe. Look at this pass he made to DiGiuseppe. And that's not all. There's more Myers content coming later in the video. So it's 3-0 Canucks at this point, and St. Louis gets a power play looking to get back in the game. But instead, 15 seconds into that power play, Pettersson decided the team needed one more goal, I guess, so he stole the puck from Torey Krug and gave it to JT Miller. Now, St. Louis could barely get anything going all game, so one might assume there wouldn't be any highlight reel Demko saves, right? Wrong.
But he bobbled it. Hronek has to hustle back to get there ahead of Shen, who gets behind him. Braden Shen! Demko with the right pad!
Demko is a demon, I'm telling you. The cherry on top was a pretty little passing play. Kuzmenko to Pettersson to Mikheyev to make it 5-0. Demko got his first shutout of the season, and the Canucks improved their record to 4-2. The next game was against the New York Rangers, and I can't lie, my hopes weren't as high going into this one. The Canucks had played the night before, and the Rangers are one of the best teams in the league, but not only did the Canucks hold their own all game, they looked just as good as the Rangers. Look at this goal. Miller basically asked Hronek to put it right on his stick, and he does. Watch how beautiful this is. This is a perfectly executed tip. Now, if you're a hockey fan, you probably know that the Rangers have had one of the deadliest power plays in the league for the past few years, so when the Canucks took a penalty in the third, I was pretty stressed. But remember when I said there's more Tyler Myers content coming later in the video? Well, look at this.
A two-man advantage in the first. Now Myers breaks it up. He's 2-on-1 with Lafferty. Tyler Myers to the net. Scores!
That's right, Myers highlights that don't involve an errant pass or tackling his own teammates. If you're one of the people who gets loud when he makes mistakes, you better be just as loud right now. Look at this play by the lovely Giraffe Man. Amazing. Shorthanded too. The Rangers went on to score two quick goals on the power play. Like I said, it's a great power play, making it 3-2 with just over 6 minutes left in the game. But Soucy wasn't ready to leave, so he blasted the puck into the back of the net to tie the game with 4 minutes left. Alright, so here's where it gets controversial. The Canucks were dominating in overtime. Just look at these scoring chances. One for JT Miller, one for Quinn Hughes, one for Kuzmenko. This would have been beautiful. Another one for Kuzmenko. But then this happened.
Towards the middle. Now leads for Pettersson. He was choked up as he put the puck between the legs. Play goes on. Three Rangers up ice. Kreider slows, cuts to the net. Centers, they score! Keandre Miller. And the fans are not happy.
Look, until AI refs take over in a couple years, bad calls and missed calls are going to be a part of the game, so I'm fine with this. Whatever. This was an amazing performance by the Canucks against a stacked Rangers team. Nothing but positives here. So after those two games, the Canucks are now 5-2-1 to start the season. That puts them second in their division, third in their conference, and fifth in the league with just 74 more games to go. Thanks, bye.
The way it ended kind of left a bitter taste in your mouth. I know the guys stood on the bench for a long time. Your take on that?
Yeah, I mean, listen, do they make mistakes? Yeah. Do we feel we deserved better? Yeah. But that doesn't mean, you know, that these guys aren't trying and they're not good refs.